What's up guys, welcome to my channel. In this video today, I will be sharing with you how you can create a SUSE Linux server on AWS, right? So to achieve this, from the search, you want to search for EC2. EC2 stands for Elastic Cloud Compute. Once you select that, you'll be landed on the EC2 page. So from here, you want to select Launch Instance. Under names and tags, specify your name for your server. So I'll be calling this SUSE Server. Under Application OS and Images, also known as Amazon Machine Image, you want to scroll down and select this icon to move across little so you can see the SUSE Linux image. So you want to select that image. From the AMI type, we're going to be keeping the default so we can benefit from this free tier. You can always scale up and scale down later. For the architecture, we're going to keep the 64-bit. And for the instance type, we're going to keep the T2.micro. Again, we want to benefit from the free tier in this tutorial. So scroll down. In order to log into your instance, you'll need a key pair. So you can use an existing key pair with your server. In your case, it's the first time you may be creating a server, so you want to select create new key pair. Specify a name for the key. I'm going to say SUSE key. For the key pair type, select RSA. For the key format, you can do PIM or PPK. If you're using an application like, say, FileZilla, then you can go with the PIM. If you're using a client like PuTTY to just SSH, then download the PPK. So for this video, I'll be connecting with PuTTY. So create key pair, and it will be automatically saved to your downloads folder. Scroll down. You can create a security group or use existing security group. I'll be creating a security group. For allow traffic, you can allow for anywhere. However, I'm going to select my IP only. So this allows everybody. Allow from anywhere, anybody around the world can connect to your server once they have your public IP. Now scroll down, you can configure storage here. So you can add multiple volumes. That is if you're configuring like a production server. Over again, we want to benefit from the free tier. So we're going to keep the default as 10 gig. Now over here, you can create multiple instances. For this case, we just want one. And then once you review the information, select Launch Instance. The launch of the instance has been successfully initiated, so select the instance ID here, and it will take you to the instance console. Here the instance is in a state of pending, and within a few seconds, less than a minute, it will change to a running state. And once it changes to a running state, then we can launch PuTTY and connect to our server. So it has changed to a running state as mentioned. So select your instance ID to get the IP of your server. So you want to grab the public IP address from here. Select copy. I'm going to launch PuTTY to connect to the server. Specify your IP. Under connection, hover here to your left. Expand SSH. Expand auth. Select credentials. And then you're going to browse for that key file that you created. Once you find it, select it and select open. We're not going to select open just yet. We're going to go back to sessions and save the session so we don't have to do this each time. So I'm just going to save it as the IP and say SUSE. So let's say save. Now when I do this, and let's say I close PuTTY, let's launch PuTTY again. I could just select the save session, select load, and then select open. So I don't have to browse for my private key again. So the default user to connect with is EC2 user. So once you enter the username, select enter, and we are in. So that's how you create and connect to your EC2 server. So that's it for now guys. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.